Because in knowing you, Jesus, there is no greater thing. Lord, it's easy to declare that with our lips. But our God is our first priority, our highest pursuit, that which we follow after more than anything else. That He is our all, that He's the best. He's our joy, our righteousness. Lord, it's easy to declare those things. It's much harder to live that reality out. Because there's so many things that fight for our attention, fight for our affections, that distract us, that pull us away from you. Or the relationship you had with your people, Israel, in the Old Testament. You called them your people. You declared it. That you would be their God. You called them to follow. To be a people set apart from the world. A people unto you. But Lord, they so often turned away and rejected you for the things of this world. And because of that, there were consequences. Captivity. But Lord, your promises endure. You keep calling us back. You keep calling us to follow. Lord, we see it in the New Testament as well, that Jesus came and He called His disciples. He said, come follow me. And some followed. Some turned away. Some followed for a time, as long as it was meeting their expectations and fulfilling that which they wanted out of Jesus. Lord, help us to be people who search after you, who call out your name, who desire you above everything else. And when we search you out, we find you. Because you're there to be found. You're calling us to yourself. Thank you this time.